When Toyota launched the FJ Cruiser back in 2006, they had real high hopes for this vehicle. After all, it makes a lot of sense. A lot of utility, you got the suicide doors, it could go anywhere and do anything. You know, this is a tribute of sorts to the original FJ Cruiser back in 1960. That's right, those were those Jeep-looking things that were practically indestructible. And that's the best way I can describe the FJ Cruiser today, is if you want to get a Jeep Wrangler, but you want something that's got Japanese quality and Japanese technology, this might be your ride. Toyota deserves a lot of credit for staying true to the FJ's heritage. As you can see, a lot of instrumentation here, all designed to make this a capable off-road vehicle. You've got compass here, angle of approach. Of course, you've got a very sophisticated four-wheel drive system, the same one that you find in the Toyota Land Cruiser, one of the most capable vehicles, my personal vehicle, on the planet. Even the way Toyota mounted this high-tech stereo into the center console of the FJ Cruiser makes it feel like a military vehicle. I even love this military green color. It just makes me feel like I could go anywhere and do anything. The problem is that while this is a very capable off-road vehicle, it's not the most comfortable vehicle to take around town. For example, the C-pillar in this vehicle is one of the widest C-pillars, measures about 18 inches, and when you're looking at the angle, it's almost like 3 feet of distraction, and that's a real problem. A lot of owners have complained about that. Regardless of the blind spot, this is a Toyota, which means you're gonna get one of the most reliable, dependable vehicles on the planet. Here's something you wouldn't find in a 1960 FJ, a rear view camera built into the rear view mirror. Love it. Under the hood of the FJ Cruiser is a very capable 4-liter V6 engine producing 260 horsepower. Now, the downside of this engine is it's not very efficient. In fact, Toyota says you can get 17 in the city, 21 miles per gallon on the highway. We actually got about 16 combined. From a design standpoint, you have a lot going on here with this FJ Cruiser, starting with these taillights that kind of stick out a little bit. You've got a different colored roof, so you've got white over here. I highly recommend the roof racks. They really add a lot. I think it looks a little too plain this way. And then you've got this massive C-pillar I mentioned. As you can see, just from this outside, just how wide this is. This is about 18 inches of metal that almost makes it impossible to see if there's a car in your blind spot. Now, you got a lot of plastic here, and that's designed to protect the body. So if you do take this vehicle off-roading, which you should, you scratch this up, it's not so bad. You scratch metal up, it's gonna cost you a lot of money. And even the bumper's a different color. So very busy, but very functional. As with many proper off-road vehicles, the spare tire is mounted on the back. You can see you got some nice FJ graphics with the tire tread here. Again, trying to make the car look very tough, very beefy, and you know, it somewhat is. The tailgate swings out, and you've got this very tiny rear window, which again contributes to poor visibility. In here, you've got certainly ample storage space. I think in many ways it's much more functional than a Jeep Wrangler because it is closed in. But if you're looking for that open airness, it may not work for you. Now, the suicide doors do add a certain element of coolness, and it's better than not having anything back here. But let's be honest, this is not exactly the back seat you want to spend a whole lot of time in. Most FJ Cruisers that you're going to find on the lot are going to have a 5-speed automatic transmission. It's a very capable transmission, but not the most efficient in the era of 6-, 7-, and 8-speed automatics. As you can hear, it's kind of a whiny, loud engine, especially since it's a 6-cylinder, not a 4-cylinder. But it is, it is capable. As a driver's vehicle, it's not the greatest because of the way the windshield sits up, very vertical. You're going to get a lot of wind noise, and because of the tires, you're going to get a lot of road noise. So going to be a pretty noisy ride for the most part. This vehicle is designed to go off-road. If you're not going to take it off-roading, probably not the vehicle you want. You got a lot better ways you can spend $30,000 to $35,000.